Ladies and gentlemen, the Bunkhouse Battle Royal. The wrestlers may wear anything they want into the ring as they are thrown over the top rope and hit the ground, they will be eliminated. The last wrestler left in the ring will be declared the winner and win $50,000. Here are the participants.
How much did he say?
50,000. We're underway here in the Boston Garden. Gorilla Monsoon at ringside with Lord Alfred Hayes, and you heard what's coming down. The Bunkhouse Battle Royal, $50,000 to the winner. Figures like that might get me out of retirement, Alfred.
It
maybe really you, in fact, for that.
It shook me up, I can tell you that.
$50,000, I love it.
I would love to have won $50,000 10 years ago.
Yes, it was worth about $1.39 today, I guess.
Hillbilly Jim.
Here they come now.
Well, I would say he's one of the favorites for $50,000, wouldn't you?
I think so.
Jimmy Jack Funk.
He would like $50,000.
We're going to see some strange attire here as they're allowed to wear anything they like.
Leaping Lanny Poffo.
What's Leaping got?
Sika. Obama. I love it.
Sika just wearing his face.
The Golden Boy, Danny Spivey. Mike Rotundo.
I would say that Mike Rotundo is one of the dark horses here.
Absolutely.
A very capable
Greg
young
the
man.
Hammer, Valentine, and Brutus Beefcake. The Islanders, Haku and Tama. Dick the Rebel Slater. Corporal Kirchner. Cowboy Bob Orton. Jim the Anvil Neidhart. Mr. Fuji. Black Jack Mulligan.
Mulligan got a great ovation from the crowd here. They obviously think he has an excellent chance of walking out with the money.
The devious one,
the magnificent Morocco.
Number 64 coming down the runway.
Pete Doherty.
Not even sure what building he's in.
Bundy.
He's just got his plain old street clothes on. You can wear anything you like in this Bunkhouse Battle Royal.
Bundy dressed all in black. He's obviously in mourning for somebody.
Oh, the bell's going. Mayhem will begin. It's everybody for themselves. Look at the poet laureate of the World Wrestling Federation, his suit of armor.
Nobody seems to want to get near him.
Oh, look at that. JJ just took a shot at him and the lid went down and he ran into steel.
And Sika is halfway out of the ring. Kirshner's got him, but doesn't seem to be able to quite get him out.
I don't think Leaping Lanny can see too well when that faceplate is down.
No, that might prove to be not such an advantage for him after all. God.
Uh-oh, look at this. Morocco going to work on Hillbilly Jim, and he gets saved by Haku.
Nobody seems to want to take on Bundy. That is, until now, Hillbilly Jim spotted him hiding in the corner there.
Uh-oh, the anvil is out of it.
Anvil gone. The fastest to go. That's a surprise. That's
there goes Mr. Fuji.
Fuji gone as well. He doesn't like that. Fuji landing heavily on his back on the apron there. Somebody's already ripped the attire of Greg the Hammer Valentine.
Slugging it out in the corner, Hillbilly Jim and King Kong Bundy. Two, I'm sure, big favorites in this Bunkhouse Battle Royal.
And Bob Orton has something wrapped around the neck of Dick Slater.
Look out! He's not out of there. He didn't go on the floor. He only made it to the apron.
Seeker thought he had Rotundo out, but Rotundo right back in again, trying to drag the remnants of his shirt round his shoulders. Oh, Bundy really belabored.
Spivey is out of there.
Spivey out. Spivey gone.
They're getting eliminated in a hurry here.
And they're ganging up on Bundy here. That is Kirchner and Rotundo both trying to get rid of Bundy. And I surely hope he doesn't come over here.
Well, the ring has been specially reinforced for this matchup. And Bundy about to drop down here onto our broadcast position. No, he got out.
They just couldn't get that 450 pounds over the top rope. And still the Duke is in there, hammering away at Morocco, of all people. Kirchner and Slater have Orton trapped in one corner. And somebody halfway out the ring, I can't quite make out who that is.
Oh, look out.
One gone.
Scotty McGee is out.
Scotty McGee's gone. And that Brutus Beefcake was almost gone, but managed to get back in again.
Corporal slugging it out with Sika here. Look at Orton, he doesn't have a clue where he is.
No, and Tama now is on the receiving end from Bundy and Brutus Beefcake.
Stretcher being called for on the far side of the ring.
Somebody down there and cannot move.
Scotty McGee. Certainly, I hope that he didn't re-injure that back of his.
My word, the Duke has just been slammed in the middle of this ring. That could be disaster.
And it's Orton, but he didn't make it to the floor. He's still in there.
Orton's still there.
Slater trying to put the boots to him.
Orton came out through the middle rope anyway. He didn't go over the top.
Has been eliminated.
And still the Duke is in there, believe it or not.
Hillbilly
Jim has nearly got Morocco over the top rope. Manages to hold on.
The big guns are still all in there. As the Rebel's got his belt off and he's whacking people with it, I think that's what's busted open a couple of guys.
And Brutus is gone by the look of things.
Definitely, he's out.
And Bob Orton's over.
He's out. And so is Jimmy Jack.
Jimmy Jack's out. Haku got rid of Orton and Slater. Morocco is dangling on the top rope. Black Jack Mulligan has got him. And he just seems to be holding on.
Look at Orton is helping him stay in there. And Hillbilly's still going to work on Bundy, and there goes
Bundy
Hillbilly.
Eliminates Hillbilly Jim. And Haku is trying to eliminate Bundy. Mulligan is almost gone. Mulligan is just hanging in.
Haku saved him right there as he was suspended in midair by Sika. kinds of action still going on. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 men still left in this Bunkhouse Battle Royal. Atomic drop on the Duke, but he's still in there. Oh, and there goes Sika, there goes Valentine.
Valentine's gone. Both out. And there goes Rotondo. Rotondo's gone.
Well.
And there goes Haku. Haku's gone. We're down to six men. We're
there
down
goes
to five.
Tama
gone from a great height. And believe it or not, one of the last five is still the Duke. The Duke of Dorchester.
Reversal, Morocco up.
Morocco's getting gone.
He's hanging on. He's still in there. No, he's just gone. Oh, look out.
That means four men. The corporal, Doherty. The corporal's gone. Big Black Jack Mulligan, King Kong Bundy, and Doherty are the last three remaining. And they're both ganging up on Mulligan.
The Duke of Dorchester still left in there with King Kong Bundy, and he's giving directions now to the Duke. He's saying, you go up to the top. Oh, look at that. He's sucking him from behind.
Bundy's got rid of Doherty. That was really a treacherous act there by Bundy.
Boy, did he sucker him.
Which just leaves the two biggest men left. Bundy, of course.
Look at
Black Jack Mulligan.
He's coming back in. He's got a steel chair. Oh, look at that. He gave a shot to Bundy.
Bundy's angry. Look at Bundy. Blackjack's got his boot.
Oh, right in the side of the head. And look out. There goes Bundy. And the winner, Blackjack Mulligan. And the Duke goes out once more.
Mulligan making sure that everybody knows he's the winner.
Bunkhouse Battle Royal, and there's your winner.
And the winner of the Bunkhouse Battle Royal, Black Jack Mulligan.
Black Jack Mulligan is saying that he was going to come here and raise havoc in the World Wrestling Federation. He certainly has done that in winning this $50,000 Bunkhouse Battle Royal. Here's what happened right at the end. The Duke was suckered by Bundy, and the Duke came back in with a steel chair and did a number while he distracted him anyway.
Up, hit him from behind with that boot. Boom! Bundy was halfway up there, and Mulligan finished him off. Mulligan himself had been in trouble many times throughout this, but managed to hang in there. Bundy gone, leaving that man there, Mulligan, the winner. For good measure, here goes Doherty.
That's the second time for the Duke of Dorchester. He was eliminated earlier on, but victorious here, and rightly so, for the Bunkhouse Battle Royal from Texas, Big Black Jack Mulligan.
Making 1987 his year.